sports make that big impact this game to really crack things open. Because Natalia, so heavily snowball oriented, but if the peel coming in from Kufra is going to be more than enough, this might be BTK's game.
Well, let's see how it goes here. It is gonna all come down to the execution. Suntech, make some noise. Game number one is on the way for the upper bracket finals. BTK going up against Onyx PH.
Game's already begun here, and the lane assignment's very clean. Nothing too out of the ordinary. Most importantly, we need to keep our eyes on where is Natalia going to strike first. Does she want to go immediately into enemy territory by the jungle? Oh, BTK, they've already have the setup for it to make sure that all the exits are going to... Sorry, all the entry points to the jungle is covered.
Yeah, not just the entry point, but also securing that little wanderer. Very, very huge for BTK here in the early game, but they need to be careful. BTK, they need to understand that Moba Zane can't really do anything until that level 4 power spike. Well, look at this, boys. He's already doing so much damage. Zia is going to get taken down by Hatred. An amazing first blood by Razor from Onyx Philippines.
They just flicker onto Hatred into the BTK lineup in front of the Kufra as well as the Lilia. How crazy is that?
Wait, oh, no. They find another kill on that bottom side. Fly Chicken is winning his matchup.
You can see the flicker was actually really, really good for the side of White Chicken. Marquee kind of panicked a little bit in that last moment, and the Kufra was able to capitalize. But so far, it is still better for the side of Onyx Philippines. Remember, the kill was taken by Hatred. Yep. Meanwhile, BTK, it was taken by Shark.
I love the order fix from BTK because they picked up the Nanon first, thinking Onyx PH thinking that it will be in the gold lane for Fire Chicken. They switch it up. They went for the Kimmy so that it will have a better lane against the Nanon. But this time Brody versus Kimmy, it's very 50-50. You can even say that it might be Brody sided.
Yeah, honestly, but wait a minute. Beloisky needs to be careful. You can't really jump into that. They will back away, but this turtle, who has pressure on it? Right now, it's BTK.
I mean, they're struggling to get pressure because the most important thing for BTK is keep in mind that Beloisky is going to be in the stealth form. The moment they know his position, they have much more of an understanding on where they want to start positioning themselves on the map and, more importantly, protecting their backline.
Okay, Kyrie gonna start this turtle up. Shark opening up the map right now, but it's gonna be Beloisky right there going up onto Zia. Black Dragon form to zone them away as Beloisky is just gonna use that to zone and take the turtle from BTK. Onyx picks up the first turtle of the game. Passion made possible by the Singapore Tourism Board.
Now, looking how the way BTK is playing, they don't mind sacrificing these neutral objectives because they scale at the end of the day. They're going to have supreme scaling, in matter of fact, with both of their marksmen on their side, and even Zia being able to keep up with them. It's going to be tough because Kyrie will start to eventually fall off.
Yeah, I do agree with that, especially with Akimi. If you don't get turrets after the first few minutes of the game, you're going to be struggling when it comes to dealing the damage, and it is true for Onyx Philippines. They're kind of all in the early game. For BTK, if they just sit back and relax, just farm it out, make sure that their lanes are managed, maybe they can take us to the late game with better arsenal compared to Onyx PH.
Yeah, honestly, right now it's going to be a very, very interesting dynamic because BTK, they're playing it really, really safe. And look at the pathing coming in from BTK. Moba Zane always on the opposite side of Kyrie. This is amazing.
Yep, it's really, really good here because the most important thing is to protect that Brody lane. You want to play generally down towards that bottom side and make sure that Brody doesn't get punished because it's hard to hurt Esmeralda overall.
We can see right now Hatred popping in the feather airstrike to be able to zone away people from the mid lane. Beloisky will be able to chunk Moba Zane a little bit as Hatred, again, doesn't have the feather airstrike, can't really contest, can't really poke him a little bit anymore. But Kyrie and Onyx, they're waiting for something here.
No, this is good. They're waiting for BTK to make that first mistake here. Shark going for a big setup overall, but you can tell that BTK making sure they are... Oh, hold on.
Whoa, Black Shoes actually popped Kyrie. Amazing, amazing read right there, but Onyx PH still only in the 200 gold lead.
Little bit of pressure for bottom lane. This would be good for BTK.
Oh, Marky's got to be careful. We'll be able to get the vision. Oh, Shark! Ooh. What was that? Tyrus Revenge and the flicker out of nowhere. Didn't even expect it. Marky still has the flicker.
Beautiful, beautiful flicker into Tyrant's Rage there. Because every time you see it, you never really can react to the overall flicker mechanic. It just happens so fast and you think, man, it looks like someone's trolling. Tyrant Rage in a weird direction, suddenly flickering on top of you. Good play coming in from Shark.
A wonderful play. Now, Onyx PH, their answer is to get the neutral objectives. For BTK, they have snatched the lead back to their side, and Taking down the outer turret energy shields in the bottom lane is going to be big for Fly Chicken. The kills that they were getting onto Marky, 0 and 2 for now, is going good for BTK because it means that you're stopping the snowball off of Kimmy.
Absolutely. This is the thing right now. BTK, they're just scaling at this point, right? They're not looking for fights. They're only looking for picks all over the map. And right now, they're playing their lane matchups really, really well. Ooh. The Kimmy hasn't been able to do anything in that gold lane. But wait a minute, Kyrie going in very aggressively onto Mobile Zane. Okay. And that is going to be him still trying to run away. No way! Mobile Zane! He's finally going to get taken down as Kyrie looks for a double kill right there. Jalarski will be the one picking up. Zia now trying to get away with the black shoes. He's only going to be taken back to where he's from. That's going to be the Tyrus Revenge connecting onto Jalarski, knocking them back and securing that peel for BTK, but it is a 2-0 trade.
It was a good adaption coming in from Onyx PH. They had a solid read that he would be on towards the top side of the map, and now, most importantly, they have the scouting Beloyski. He's really playing with fire.
Oh, Shark going in for the Titan's Rage, and that's going to be the Torn Apart Memory to pick up the kill, equalizing once more BTK.
Oh, Shark really is a game changer for BTK. So far has been there for 3 kills of BTK. In fact, he got 2 because of his initiations and that counterplay, allowing Fly Chicken to get another kill, this time on Beloyski. This is amazing for BTK. And the lead that Onyx PH at 830 gold, this is not what you want if you're just looking at their lineup. In fact, BTK, despite them struggling a little bit, this is actually
Blue
pretty good for the team.
Has been destroyed.
How good can it get, though? They want to start pressing their leads. They're pushing it on towards that top side. Yes, turtles are falling into Onyx PH's side, but one bad fight could really turn the favorites into BTK.
This is not good for the side of Onyx Philippines, honestly, right? They need more than just 300 gold. The Beloyski going on to Fly Chicken. That's got a lot of damage placed, but the amazing flicker and the bouncing ball at the right moment will be able to ensure his safety again. Onyx PH, they've been in control of these turtles, but right now it is only a 700 gold lead built up.
Man, Beloyski, he's such a team player. He did not want to use his execute. He really wanted to get the kill.
Oh, wait a minute. Shark is going to get caught, and that's going to be him taken down right there. Titan's Revenge unable to connect as Jalarski will be able to zone 4 members away. Kyrie picking up the turtle the third time in this game.
Oh, it's good. It's so good. And awkward timing, yes, of course, that we wanted to see Onyx PH really start pushing, putting some gas onto this fire. But they've already started the ignition.
Oh, look at that. Beloyski needs to be careful. Fly Chicken able to get the stun. Torn Apart Memory as well. He's still able to get out. But that is amazing from Fly Chicken. The fact that he is able to withstand this damage most probably is because of those items.
I love the fact that Onyx PH actually went into Shark and really punished him. That guy has been the problem for Onyx PH because when they want to go for the jump, Shark is always there for the counter initiation play. And they went and burst this Kufra. This means that Onyx PH will have a lot of priority onto this hero. But Kufra already has got the Athena shield perfect against Onyx PH.
Onyx PH, they might be looking for an engage here. Entropy being used by Mobile Zane, dealing some damage, but Beloyski will be able to bait away the... Oh, Black Shoes! Beloyski's gonna get bursted down. Oh! Air Strike by Hatred! Picks up a kill on the other side. Mobile Zane, 2 times already picked off in this game.
Wow. Good flicker coming in from Hatred here. Beloyski with a good read. Most importantly, understanding he will die, but he will bait out this fight. Oh. Nicely done by Onyx PH.
It's always the alley-oop coming up from Beloyski. Not scared of dying. All he has to do is to deal the damage and eventually Hatred will force that because BTK, the way that they're saving their teammates is that they group up together and it makes total sense for this Farsa to just use and pop that ultimate and eventually Onyx PH will go for the cleanup. This time, Hatred is on the mark, especially with that flicker play.
Right now, as it seems, Onyx PH building up that 2,000 gold lead, and the Kimmy is scaling very, very well. Let's see Shark going in. Tyrant's Rage unable to connect. It is going to be them going for the re-engage for the airstrike. The docks from Shark down right now. Jalarski dives the back line. Beloyski picks up the kill. Moba Zane is nowhere to go. Marky gets another, and Moba Zane will die for the third time in this game. BTK looking for something though. Turn up on memory. Almost taking Marky down now. Victor going in onto the backside. Let's see if he can do anything. Oh. He's going to get stunned up. Onyx Philippines with the amazing front to back will be able to win it out. Zia popping in black shoes as Fly Chicken. Kyrie, look at him! What the heck was that? Kyrie and Hatred, the dynamic duo, getting it done 4-0.
Oh my god. Hatred!
Hatred, man.
If he doesn't get MVP, I'm gonna be very upset. He is making everything happen. Let's look at this replay one more time and just break it down because overall, this fight is all about being able to peel. Hatred is able to get the stun at the right moment. it, and it helps that Marky first item Ice Queens want and sacrifice
look at Kyrie.
His lane.
Okay. Where you go, you shall not pass, says Kyrie. Man. And hatred just the icing on the top. Everybody is on point from Onyx PH. I think that they really turned it up. And the fact that they're coordinating all their skills, that might be the Onyx magic that we're looking for. Hatred with the stuns, really stopping Victor from his tracks. And that was wasn't the only time he did that stun. He actually stunned Mobazane so that Dilarski will be able to catch up. And boy, Onyx PH eventually gets the snowball. 5,000 gold for themselves now.
That really felt like a video game, man. BTK, yeah. they were about to lose, already losing, backing away. Then the final boss appears out of nowhere, catching him. Literally just standing there too. Look at Kyrie opening up the map with that jab. It's just going to be so good for them. This map pressure is so good for Onyx Philippines. Look at how they're able to control the map. And Shark, he's unable to do anything here because of that vision.
I mean, it's fine for now. BTK can understand if they have one turnaround fight, the gold evens out and it goes back to a neutral state. But for Onyx PH, they just need to manage their ways. Look at how they're doing it.
This Natalia coming out from Baloyski is starting to be a lot of problem for BTK and maybe for the next teams that will face Onyx PH or maybe the next few games, because this has been a championship hero for Baloyski.
Oh, for the airstrike, almost taking them down, as that's going to be BTK forced to back away from their tier 2. Lord marching down again here in that top side. It is going to be Kyrie and Baloyski trying to do the same onto the mid and the bottom side. Baloyski on that Natalia will pick up the tier 2 in the bottom side, building up to a 6.7 now, 1,000 gold lead.
I'm so curious what Hatred's items is right now. I just saw him get the Winter Strunge. I'm not sure if it's third or second, but look at that damage. I'm guessing it's probably his third.
Oh my god, beautiful movements and beautiful poke. As Baloyski is going to dive onto Mobazane, that's a little bit too aggressive. He's going to get picked up, but it's all going to be worth it. It bought so much time for Onyx. The banana split coming in. What time is it? It's Onyx time.
How beautiful that was that. I mean, Baloyski didn't even get the kill, but they still got a push.
Oh my god, look at the engage coming from Shark. Oh, able to get Dilarski there, but it's going to be Hatred popping in for the airstrike. Now Flychicken jumping in with a torn apart memory. The Winter's Truncheon saves him once more as they're going to go for the turn. Zia popping in the black shoe, still able to run away for now, but it's going to be Marky chasing him down, taking him down. Killing spree picked up as that is a 2-4-0. The fact of the matter is BTK, they are unable to get even a single kill on the board.
It's the timing, it's the item power spikes coming in from Onyx PH. The situational items are really getting a lot of value to help them press their lead.
I agree with that because of the fact that Winter Truncheon really bought so much time, and BTK, they were so into getting down, taking down Hatred, and they're really just so focused in that. They're tunneling into that vision of trying to shut down Hatred. Even with a jump coming out from Victor, wasn't able to stop Hatred from popping the ultimate. In fact, Hatred stayed in front of Victor for quite a long time before popping that Winter Truncheon in the most perfect moment where BTK was already so overcommitted.
At this point, you can call him the Winter King, man, because that is the plays that he's able to do in the world stage constantly against RRQ and now against BTK. Onyx pushing the pace with the 7,000 gold lead, manipulating those waves, waiting for the Lord.
Still, if you're looking at BTK, still have to look at their scaling. For Onyx PH, it's true that their split push has been doing well. They have been getting this macro lead and they have been snowballing. But you'd never ever have to underestimate the scaling of both the Nadan as well as the Brody. They still will be stronger when the gold is even. Maybe around the 20-minute mark when everything is just equalized. BTK, as long as they hang on to their base, this is still winnable for them.
I mean, this is going to be nerve-wracking, especially for Flychicken. He went to optimally build very defensively, getting two early defensive item components in the Juggernaut armor, making sure that he could survive. But he's only got a Blade of Despair right now, and he needs way more damage. He understands that he's going to get an item power spike later on. They just need to survive through this onslaught.
Oh man, that feather airstrike. Oh my god! They keep doing this. Baloyski, his positioning is immaculate. The brilliant display of the banana split once again for Onyx.
The coordination between Hatred and Baloyski has been phenomenal. For the longest time, Onyx PH has been playing with Baloyski in the mid lane role, but this time Hatred shining with these mages.
Oh my god, for the airstrike, able to take free chicken so low, but Baloyski! What is this? He keeps getting the kills. Kyrie jumping to the backside, aiming to zone Victor and Shark away from the turrets, but that is all they need, man. Just one by one taking it, and now the Lord, Enhanced Lord, spawns.
Yeah. Oh, Oh my goodness, they're pressing their advantage, and most importantly, we see the numbers 15-5, 10k gold lead, 14 minutes into the game. In situations like this, they've got about 3 minutes to survive for BTK.
Baloyski is the name of the game. He's gonna go back in. Victor's gonna be chased, and the Shark Man will try to go for more, but he's gonna get taken down, boxed away. Look at Victor, he's trying to save the game, but the base will simply be targeted, and Onyx PH will reign supreme in game one.
Oh my goodness, Baloyski to Hatred. That's an alley-oop once again. So many times it happened in this game. And look at the face of the guy. Game face on. Hatred is angry and he's not gonna stop. Look at the confidence of these guys.